Country Concerts. On behalf of me, I'm Randy. My wife Cheryl sits down here in the blue shirt. If it's your first time here, or if you came with somebody else, first time here, whatever. If you're not on the mail list, in on the bar, there's a notebook. Jot your email address down. I'll keep you informed of all the shows. If also on the bar, some postcards, business cards, out to your friends, family, whatever. Also on the bar, fancy right here, Oak Tree Concerts koozies. They're $3 a piece, 2 for $5. Somebody didn't have one. This is the point I normally tell you about our next show, but unfortunately, I don't have anything booked yet. I had something booked and it's falling through on me, so watch for an email, working on a few things. I guess on with Chuck here. Been a fan of Chuck's music for many years and super excited to have him here to the house, so everybody put your hands together for Chuck Mead.
Thanks, guys. Cherry, won't you come along with me? We're right down outside the town where nobody else would be. We'll head to the river where the Raiders made their getaway. And we wade in up to our shins with that spilling our Beaujolais. Oh, my darling, don't ask the reason why. I'm standing knee deep in the Wakarusa wishing my feet were dry. Now there's spirits on the Greek bank and they all want some wine. Barren liquid and old beaten Nick waiting for the stars to shine. A little taste of heaven, but heaven is so small. The other side seems big and wide when you're told you can have it all. Oh, my darling, don't ask the reason why. Standing knee deep in the Wakarusa River, wishing I weren't so high. Oh, my darling, don't ask the reason why. Standing knee deep in the Wakarusa River, wishing my feet were dry. So high. Now the harvest moon is dangling like an orange in the sky. But I'll uproot my muddy boots and then we'll have to say goodbye. I love you, pretty baby, but there's something you should know. There's a staying kind and a praying kind, and the good ones always go. Oh, my darling, don't ask the reason why. I'm standing knee deep in the Wakarusa River, wishing my feet were dry. Oh, my darling, don't ask the reason why. I'm standing knee deep in the Wakarusa River, wishing I weren't so high. Same place. ponytail. Oh, over 300 men strong. And most of them wanted to get while they could get it, cause you know you don't live that long. Riding like hell with a devil by their side. In a terrible yell, they swung on down, kill the men and burn the town. They set it all alight in flames, widows were calling their husband's name. Over 150 dead, the raiders who slapped at the bloodshed. They were riding like hell with a devil by their side.
Everybody has a honky-tonk in their backyard. So I'm going to play a nice country shuffle for all you dancers out there. What's good for you is killing me. Why do you get such a thrill from my misery? You insist on breaking down my sanity. Why can't you see what's good for you is killing me? Now I go out and you stay home alone with all your schemes. I guess the things that I can't give are the things you really need. What's good for you is killing me. Why do you get such a thrill from my misery? Well, you insist on breaking down my sanity. Why can't you see what's good for you is killing me? But now I must say, you play your games oh so very well. Oh, you say you love me, you say you care, but darling, it's so hard to tell. What's good for you is killing me.
why do you get such a thrill from my misery? Oh, you insist on breaking down my sanity. Why can't you see what's good for you is killing me? Why can't you see what's good for you is killing me?
That's pretty hillbilly.
Anybody been to the western part of the state? There's a town called Neosho.
Yep.
You know Neosho?
Yeah.
Well, it's just across the line. See, I have this record out, and it's all about my home state of Kansas now. Easy. All right?
We forgive
you. All right? I know. I was born in Nevada, but I was raised in Kansas. But anyway, I went. My family had a band, and I was the drummer in the band. And I was like 13 or 14 years old, and we play these county fairs. And down by Neosho, on the Kansas side, we played a fair one time, and a lady taught me some stuff. And so I wrote a song about it. The Neosho Valley Sioux, Neosho Valley Sioux, I love you, Neosho Valley Sioux. I'm just a poor boy from Moran. Won't you let me be your man? You're my first love, Neosho Valley Sioux. Well, I went out to a little fair to find myself a sweet. I went and saw that girl by the tilt-a-whirl. Well, my heart went flip and sent me on a little trip that took me to another galaxy. Well, she led me to the stars. She was Venus, I was Mars. I won't forget you, Neosho Valley Sioux. I'm gonna try one now. Neosho Valley Sioux, I love you, Neosho Valley Sioux. I'm just a poor boy from Moran. Won't you let me be your man? You're my first love, Neosho Valley Sioux. Well, I went out to a little fair to find myself a sweet. I went and saw that girl by the tilt-a-whirl. Well, my heart went flip and sent me on a little trip that took me to another galaxy. Well, she led me to the stars. She was Venus, I was Mars. I won't forget you, Neosho Valley Sioux. That's a true story. Seriously, I don't mind heckling. Yeah, I'm worried about that part of the audience, really. But hey, thanks for inviting me out here. What a beautiful night, you know? The rain held off. It's not too hot. All right, I'll do this old song just because it's almost the end of the world. I'm going to have a theme of the end of the world, okay? Because this is how we should go out, right? Right here.
Going out to the mailbox, a new bill every week. I call up the suicide line and they don't want to speak. I picked a fight with a gas man, I bought a loss cause he's too tall. Here I am a bloody mess, waiting for the axe to fall. Well, driving down the freeway, a motor blowing fire. State trooper stopped and hauled me in cause my license had expired. Backwoods County Sheriff, he wouldn't let me make my call. got myself in a terrible fix. Wait for the axe to fall. Well, I'm sitting here counting years, my debt to society. I gave myself a crashing cold, a lesson in humility. Well, I knew that it would happen. I know I started it all. Tripping down my history, waiting for the axe to fall. I gave myself a crash course, a lesson in humility. Well, I knew that it would happen. I know I started it all. Here I sit in the bleacher seats, waiting for the axe to fall. Waiting for the axe to fall. Waiting. I'm waiting. Waiting for the axe to fall.
Okay, that made me think of this song. I haven't played it for a while, but now we're on that. You ever see that show on, I think it's on the History Channel, and it's called Life After People? You ever see that? Where it's like, here's what happened if people suddenly disappeared from the earth. No reason at all, just like there were no people left. It would look, the world would look like this 2 weeks, and then, you know, 2 months, and then 2 years, and then 10 years, and then 5 years, and then pretty soon everything, the earth just takes everything back, you know. And I always thought that was kind of beautiful because, you know, we really are kind of a pestilence on this whole planet. But what are you going to do with the beer cans, really? So anyway, my buddy and I wrote this song called After the Last Witness Is Gone. We'll sort it all out later on. Who will find out who was right or wrong? After the last. Now tell me, son, what would you think if by tomorrow we were all extinct? Some chimp would tag me as a missing link. After the last witness is gone. Today I talked to a hummingbird. He laid it out there like I never heard. He said war was just a thin out the herd. Until the last witness is gone. After the last witness is gone. We'll sort it all out later on. We'll find out who was right or wrong. After the last witness is gone. Well, would Mother Nature have a smile on her face as she said goodbye to the human race? We'll wipe away its kind of trace, redefine the beautiful world. Now maybe think that I have a point about the next in line to run this joint. Which alpha dog will God annoy? After the last witness is gone. This is the clap part. Is gone. This big rock and all out later on. Two and four guys found out who was right or wrong. After the last witness is gone. One more. After the last witness is gone. We'll sort it all out later on. We'll find out who was right or wrong. That was how many drummers? 1, 2, 3, 4. That's more drummers than Junior Brown's gone through. people know Junior. No, that's good. One guy, a friend of mine asked Junior, hey, Junior, what's your drummer's name? And he said, 37. I shouldn't be telling tales like that. That sounds name droppy, doesn't it? Okay.
Dish.
Oh no, it's no dish. That's true. You can't be offended by the truth, although some people are.
That's politically correct, right?
Well, I'm not so worried about that. I'm just into the truth. Okay, I'm going to play the song for you guys now. All right, we were talking about, these guys asked me about this thing that happened to me when I was in this band called BR549, right? I don't know. Well, we came up down there in Nashville, Tennessee on this one street called Lower Broadway. It's between 4th and 5th Avenue downtown, and it shared an alley. All these clubs shared an alley with the Ryman Auditorium, the Mother Church of Country Music. And we went down there, and there wasn't anybody down there except a bunch of homeless guys, transient guys, hustlers, peep shows, and us, and a few European tourists. It was awesome. But that was where all the hillbilly magic was, so we got drawn down there to Lower Broadway and the Tootsie's Orchid Lounge. Is, you know, that's where Farron Young and Willie Nelson and Charlie Pride and all those guys used to hang out there. And it was real important because we were trying to latch on to that hillbilly magic. And so the band played at Roberts Wednesday through Saturday, 9 to 2, no break at all for the rest of our lives. That's what we used to say. It was only a couple years, though. I was saying that earlier. But on Mondays and Sundays, I play at Tootsie's. And so one night, I was playing down there, and this thing happened, and these guys were asking me about it, and I told them that I'd tell them the story right now. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to shut up and tell you the story. Is that all right?
Yes, sir.
Is that a good lead up?
Yes, sir.
You know? Okay. All right, here we go. Well, when I first came to Nashville, I was playing in this joint downtown. Because I'd always wanted to play in the front window of Tootsie's Orchid Lounge. So Clovis and me, we got us a gig in there, playing from 9 to 2. We were getting to play whatever we wanted, and we were making a little bit of money, too. Well, one Monday night, about 10 o'clock, the crowd, it was looking thin, and we were probably only going to go home about $35 richer than when we walked in. And then suddenly, the whole place filled up. From the front bar to the back. And I looked out the front window and I seen some guy pulling up in a big long black Cadillac. I did. Well, I noticed how he tipped his hat as he walked into the bar. And I said to myself, you know, that guy has to be some big famous singing star. So I just looked over at old Clovis and we kicked off a couple of rockin' Carl Smith tunes. And then I followed it up with two or three Johnny Horton numbers. Then I started to work the room. I went into my little spiel about how you know you're supposed to tip the band. I said, if you can't give $5, well, just give what you can. And if there's anything special that you'd like to hear, well, now's the time to say. And that guy in the hat stood up and said, I'll give you $25 for every Hank Williams song you can play. Well, I was shocked and stunned and to the challenge that he had laid down before me. So I rattled off 5 Hank Williams songs in a row, and then another 3. At $300 worth, I had to kind of stop and catch my breath. But everybody in that whole joint was yelling out all their favorite Hank Williams requests. They said, hey, good looking, honky tonkin', so lonesome I could cry. Rudy Tooty, honey, baby, no Ted drops tonight. I played that rambling man from Alabama. Well, with the help of everybody in the bar that night, I did 24. He was telling me how good a job I was doing as he was stuffing $100 bills in my tip jar. But he only had $575 on him. You know, that didn't bother me. Hell, he paid for 23 of them suckers. He could have Jambalaya for free. Well, now all that happened to me many, many years ago. And since then, I've done all right, I guess. I make a living doing what I love. And that's a measure of true success. But I have to admit that every now and again, I get to thinking how Man, I sure could use that other $25 about right now.
'Cause I sang, hey, good looking honky tonk, and so lonesome I could cry. Oh, Rudy Tooty, honey, baby, no teardrops tonight. I played that rambling man from Alabama. Well, I said, I can't help it. Long gone daddy don't love me like he used to do. Oh, howling, moaning, whistle blowing, lonesome, lovesick blues. I played that rambling man from Alabama.
And that's a true story. All right, now what do we do after that little bit of comedy? What's that? Who was the guy in the hat? Well, you have to ask these guys.
John Michael Montgomery.
It was John Michael Montgomery. I didn't know who it was, really. He was just some guy. Yeah, John Michael Montgomery.
He's trying to punk him out and it didn't work.
Yeah.
That's all right. Hey, man, I talked to him later. I got a nice tattoo out of it, and I talked to him later. And he said, you know what? I just was digging what you were doing. And he had the money. And he was just at the right part of his buzz. You want to see the tattoo?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, it's not on my ass. There it is, the Hank Williams commemorative tattoo. Look at those guns, man. Look at those guns. Yeah, not the guy in the beard. The drunk guy with the beard. That's the drunk guy without the beard. All right, now what were we talking about? Oh, I was trying to call my wife and she wasn't answering the phone. I'm doing that. I was telling Gary earlier, and it reminded me of this song. This is gonna sound really. I mean, Prince Charles told me a million times never to drop names, but I was fortunate enough to become friends with some of my heroes. Like I went to Carl Perkins' house one time, and I got to, you know, do a little picking with him in his living room, and he took me out to dinner, and we were hanging out, and it was very encouraging because I guess he saw the same sort of retardation of him in the old days or something. Anyway, he was real sweet and real nice and always good. And so this was back in the days before anybody had cell phones, and I was trying to call home so that I could get Carl Perkins' number on my caller ID. But I kept calling back home, and the line was busy, you know, because I was trying to tell my wife, I'm calling from Carl Perkins' house. But it just kept being busy. And so I finally said, man, she's talking to someone. She ain't talking to me. And Carl goes, there's your song, boy. And so I did. It's been such a long time since she talked to me. Out here in this phone booth, I'm chilled to my knees. I dial her number, and I just can't believe, 'cause she's talking to someone, she ain't talking to me. She's talking to someone, she ain't talking to me. And I can't stop crying right here in the street. That signal I'm getting makes a monotone plea, 'cause she's talking to someone, she ain't talking to me. I'm fumble for quarters, I'm looking for dimes. I can't even buy her, she's busy each time. I slam the receiver and I clench my teeth. She's talking to someone, she ain't talking to me.
but she's talking to someone. She ain't talking to me, and I can't stop crying right here in the street. That signal I'm getting brings a monotone plea. She's talking to someone, she ain't talking to me.
It was all right. Thanks, Carl.
All right.
My grandpa worked on the Missouri Pacific Railroad for about 35 years, 40 years. And he always told me that when he was a kid, he wanted to work on the railroad because he had this book called On a Slow Train Through Arkansas. It was a real old book full of these corny railroad jokes. He just passed away. He's 100 years old. How about that? J.C. Wine. But before that, I got him a copy of the book for Christmas one year, and then I wrote him this song that went with it. Here you go, JC.
On a slow train through Arkansas, it's the slowest train you ever saw. Well, you know that it's a crime that this train can't make any better time. It's a slow train through Arkansas. Well, that brakeman flashes a number 6 as the cars pull along out in the sticks. This thing ain't never hit no cow, but it couldn't ever catch up with one anyhow. It's a slow train through Arkansas. Well, there ain't no shortage of homemade alcohol on that slow train through Arkansas.
Slow train through Arkansas.
Arkansas.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We've got a fallen soldier. Could you sing a song for him? Dale Reeves, he loves.
You want to hear Dale Reeves?
We love Dale Reeves. He's down. I don't know if we can get him up.
Okay. My guitar's as loud as it'll go. Now who's that girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in a field near the big old highway? So I hear them in my Jimmy hauling freight from Chicago to St. Louis. Lord, I see her every day. Well, a double-clutching weasel like me can never ever get a girl to wanna even look at him that way. Well, like a girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in a field near the big old highway. What do 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 do? What do 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 do? That girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in a field near the big old highway. Well, I bet it wouldn't take her very long to be gone if someone pulled a dirty trick and took her towel away. Well, I slow my Jimmy down to 20, that's how many wrecks I see along there every day. Caused by the girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in the field near the big old highway. What do 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 do? What do 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 do? Nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on the billboard in the field near the big old highway. Well, I bet it wouldn't take her very long to be gone if someone pulled a dirty trick and took her towel away. Well, 4:45 coffee drinking eating time, shimmy shimmies as I wake up the artist that painted that display of the girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in a field near the big old highway. What do 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 do? What do 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 do? A doggone that girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on a billboard in a field near the big old highway. Oh, sleepy-headed painter said the girl wasn't real. I should get the on my way. Whoa, Route 66 from Chicago to St. Louis. You'll see tiny pieces of my heart scattered every which way. Well, scattered by the girl wearing nothing but a smile and a towel and a picture on the billboard in the field near the big old highway. What do 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 do? What do 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 do? Is he better now?
Dear John.
Dear John?
Yeah, you know you got to do that one after that one.
You've been to my show before.
Yeah, you know it.
That's the dancing one. I can do I'll do the Hank Williams version.
Yes, sir.
When I woke up this morning, there was a note upon my door. Said, don't make me no coffee, honey, 'cause I won't be there no more. That's all she wrote. Dear John, I'll send your saddle home. Well, now she didn't leave no address, she didn't say goodbye. All she said was, if you get blue, why don't you hang your little head and cry? That's all she wrote. Dear John, I'll fetch your saddle home. Well, now my gal's short and stubby, she's strong as she can be. If that little old gal of mine ever get a hold of me, that's all she wrote. Dear John, I sent your saddle home. Well, now John, I got along in the belly of the whale, Daniel in the lion's den. But I know a guy that didn't try to get along, and he won't get a chance again. That's all she wrote. Dear John, I sent your saddle home. Well, I went down to the teller man to
teller said with a grin, I feel so sorry for you, Chaz, but your wife has done been in. That's all she wrote. Dear John, I sent your saddle home.
Okay. Am I off the hook for that one now? That's not the creepy version we usually do. You can't do that without the band, because they're creepy.
I want creepy.
Yeah, you want creepy? Awesome. You want creepy? Okay. I'll give you creepy, and I'm going to play another set. I'm going to take a break here, but I'll end on creepy for you. It's a murder ballad, okay? People love death when it's not them. This is another one of those Kansas songs. The record's for sale in there if you'd like to take some of these memories home with you, I'm sure. But this is a song that I wrote about this murder that happened in this place in South Central Kansas called Holcomb, Kansas. And it was this family that got murdered in the middle of the night, seemingly for no reason at all. And they caught these two guys that did it, and they were the last guys hung in Kansas ever. And Truman Capote wrote a big book about it called In Cold Blood. And there was a movie made in cold blood that had Robert Blake as as Perry Smith, one of the murderers, you know, typecasting, as it turns out. But it scared the shit out of me when I was a kid, that movie. And so to purge myself, I wrote a murder ballad about it and put it on a record, but I didn't want to bum everybody out, so I put it to a rockabilly beat, all right? Just so no one gets bored with it, all right?
Got in a little trouble, 1959. When they let me out of prison, I didn't have a dime. I went to see my old cellmate. He had a brand new plan that would lead us to riches and the promised land. Well, my daddy disowned me and my mama's dead. But the voices still call me from inside my head. On a dark road in Kansas, me and my best friend, blowing through the prairie in an evil wind. I said, blowing, blowing, blowing through the prairie in an evil wind. Blowing, blowing, blowing through the prairie. Well, there was an old farmer. He had a big fat safe. We were gonna take it and then leave that place. Wasn't gonna be no witness, my buddy said to me, as we went rolling down the highway to our destiny. Well, we came up to the farmhouse. It was like a dream. Oh, there wasn't no treasure, just a family. I couldn't take it any longer, I had to make it in. Gunfire echoed across an evil wind. The border down to Mexico. $45 and a radio. But the hookers and tequila all ran out soon. And our little joyride turned into a bad honeymoon. Oh, the law, they caught us, and they locked us away. And now they lead me to the gallows beside my best friend. We'll be swinging in a quarter in an evil wind. I said, blowin', blowing, blowing through the prairie in the evil wind. Blowing, blowing, blowing through the prairie in the evil wind. Blowing, blowing, blowing.
I'm gonna take a break. I'll come back and play some more. Don't go anywhere. I mean, you're kind of trapped in the woods, aren't you?